going to get dark.
So your magic's useful after all.
Fate is a young adult fantasy show. It's a big, broad fantasy show. It's got a little bit of horror in it. It's got some great coming-of-age tales in it. That very basic question, which is, who am I? And everybody goes through that. I used to work on a show called The Vampire Diaries, and The Vampire Diaries did this great thing of being a vampire show that was really just a grounded teen show. And Netflix had this show called The Winx Club, and they wanted to take an audience that had watched this cartoon growing up and give them a new version of it.
I'm sure it must be overwhelming, an entirely new world.
I always talk about this show as the origin story of a friend group. And as you get older, you always look back on that group of friends that you had when you were younger. It was important for me that the core idea of friendship was present in this version of the show, because that's what Winx is. We wanted to play within the Winx world, but we also wanted to introduce new storylines and characters, like Winx suite member Tara and her brother Sam, who are cousins of Flora, who was in the original cartoon. We've also got troublemaker Beatrix, who might remind fans of one of the Trix sisters.
Excuse me?
I'll just take a water. Room temp. Thanks, love.
We are injecting life and death stakes like instantaneously on these girls and these fairies and specialists who have been trained for war but haven't experienced war yet and maybe feeling like they're not ready. They're not ready to face the challenges that they face, and it doesn't matter, and them having to be ready regardless.
Fate is a story about a boarding school for fairies.
It's like a normal school, except you're also learning magic.
And they go in their teenage years to start learning about their powers and learning how to use them.
It focuses on one suite, and ours is the Winx suite. So there's five girls all living there, and they all have different kind of fairy powers. And it's about them uncovering the secrets of the school and using their powers together to fight evil.
The history of this place is a lot darker than Dowling and the rest of the faculty want us to know. I want that truth.
Bloom is a fire fairy who grew up in the first world, so she did not grow up in the other world.
And what realm are you from?
California. And she finds out, kind of by accident, that she has these powers. Throughout season one, it's following her journey with learning how to control them.
Fairy magic is linked to emotion. Could be good thoughts, could be bad, love, hatred. Stella has control over light. Well, I say control. She attempts to have control over light. She's a very complex girl. She appears a certain way, but she's actually a lot softer, and she's got a lot of barriers that need to be broken down.
Aisha is a water fairy. From the offset, she seems quite confident with her powers, but because she's a perfectionist, she doesn't think that's good enough, and she wants to always be developing.
Tara's power is all plant-based. It's growing things and sending them off after people. She is the most welcoming. She loves it. She loves to meet new people. She gives too much.
Musa is an empath. Her power is to feel everyone's emotions, whether it be nature or anything around. She's just open and honest, but also she's not honest with herself, and she's trying to learn how to do that.
You know, it follows their story of becoming friends in this first year, the ups and downs of it, and really portrays the loyalty and trust and support in female friendships.
How do you know how to steal a car?
I know how to do a lot of things.
It doesn't just show the positive side of friendship, it also shows the hardships as well.
Yes, it's slightly more complicated when you add a boy into the mix.
Yeah, I mean, they're going to be love triangles. I think they're always going to be ups and downs, just as any friendship.
All the girls are just a great time. We all get on really, really well.
Abby is so wild and so carefree.
And also, she's got the funniest and loudest laugh I've ever heard in my life.
Hannah is the opposite of Stella. She is absolutely lovely.
Alicia, who is absolutely gorgeous. I've never known someone who will listen to you just like she does.
Precious is so funny.
The coolest human ever.
Honestly, Elliot, I feel like, is the comedian of the group. I mean, they're all hilarious. They're never not joking around.
It's very easy for us to, like, just be around each other all the time. We are around each other all the time.
We've been so lucky. We've been filming on set on the Winx suite, which is in Bray and Ardmore Studios. Kilroy House, which is these beautiful grounds. There's an amazing conservatory and a castle.
They're beautiful.
absolutely beautiful locations.
I've loved being an island. I love it here. Everybody's so lovely all of the time.
The cast, the crew, the producers, everyone just builds each other up in such a fantastic way.
Fate is love, friendship.
Get dressed. We're going to go to the party. We're going to show everybody that we're cool and hot.
Betrayal.
You can't see how it's a problem.
I thought it didn't matter what other people thought.
Dark and mysterious.
What the hell is that thing?
You know, gritty and cool.
Action and adventure.
Maybe a little bit of saucy moments.
And a lot of other things.
We'll discuss consequences in the morning.
Is she like detention pissed off or expulsion pissed off?
I'm going with the first one, but only because of the tiny bit of pride I also felt in there.